It's AumSum time!
Huh?
Why do we fart?
Cause we like to spread some fragrance.
Ew, no. Farting or flatulence is a natural process. It involves the release of intestinal gas through anus. An average person farts about 10 to 20 times a day, and there are various reasons behind this. While eating food, we also swallow air. So, this air either comes out as burps or travels through the entire intestinal tract, and escapes as a non-smelly fart. So, what makes some farts stink? High-fiber foods like beans and broccoli have a sugar called raffinose. Humans lack the enzyme to digest raffinose. So, when undigested raffinose enters the large intestine, trillions of good bacteria break it down and release gases like methane, hydrogen sulfide, etc., which makes farts stinky. Some people even lack the enzyme that digests lactose. So, when these people eat cheese or ice creams, they end up releasing stinky farts. Are preservatives bad for you?
I don't know what they are, so they must be good for me.
No. Wait, I'll explain. A preservative is a substance added to foods, cosmetics, medicines, etc. to prevent them from spoiling. For example, preservatives like salt and sugar prevent the growth of harmful microbes in foods, thus preventing them from spoiling. However, a high amount of salt and sugar can increase the risk of diabetes, high blood pressure, heart diseases, etc. Some food items even have preservatives like benzoic acid to inhibit the growth of harmful microbes. But benzoic acid is said to cause hyperactivity in children, asthma, etc. Sorbic acid, which is used in cosmetics, can cause skin irritation. In people suffering from asthma, preservatives like sulfites can cause very serious problems like difficulty in breathing, tightness in chest, etc. Hence, it is very important to check the preservatives used and have them in moderate amounts. Why do cats purr?
To keep their voice melodious.
Nah. According to a popular belief, people think that cats purr when they are happy and satisfied. But did you know that cats purr in other situations also? Imagine a cat falls from a height and injures her bone. In such a situation also, the cat starts purring to heal her bones.
Purring? To heal the bones? But how's that possible?
It is found that exposure to frequencies between 20 Hz and 50 Hz builds bone density, and the frequency of a cat's purr falls within the range of 25 Hz to 150 Hz. So, it is possible that a cat who has injured her bone might be purring to build bone density and thus promote healing.
Whoa! That's awesome, dude!
In addition to this, cats also purr when they are stressed or feeling very hungry. What is diabetes?
A rare diamond!
No. Diabetes is a disease in which glucose or sugar levels in our blood remain high.
Is it higher than the Statue of Liberty?
Nah. Most of our food is converted into glucose and released into the bloodstream. Then, our pancreas makes insulin. Insulin helps glucose get into the cells. However, in some people, the insulin production is inadequate or it is not used well. Hence, glucose stays and builds up in the blood, increasing the blood glucose level and thus causing diabetes. There are three main types of diabetes. Diabetes type 1 occurs when our immune cells destroy the cells in pancreas, which make insulin, resulting in less or no insulin production. Diabetes type 2 occurs when pancreas cannot produce enough insulin or our bodies cannot use it well. Gestational diabetes occurs in pregnant women. Diabetes can lead to blindness, kidney failure, heart attacks, etc. Hence, diabetic people should always maintain their blood glucose levels.